When our kids become teenagers, we suddenly realize we only have a few more years left with them and we want to make the best of that time. But it's often a time when we're trying to figure out what's the next phase of our life. So I'm going to explain what happened to me in my motherhood journey to help me realize how to reconcile those two things at this point in my life. I'm Mocha Mom. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior, where we help you stomp the stress and dump the self-judgment by relating to stories of other moms who share their successes and their failures. And I've had plenty of them. Yeah, some successes, yes, a lot of failures. And now I'm at the point where I'm pursuing something that I know is really important to me at a time when my kids are teenagers and one of them is going through a lot of difficulties herself. So I have to figure out the balance of making sure I'm there for them and especially for her, but not being overbearing and still paying attention to my new endeavor in my own life and my career. In my motherhood journey, I realized that I wasn't being the kind of mom I wanted to my kids because I was stressed out all the time. I was yelling all the time. I was trying to do too much. I wasn't reaching out for help enough. I wasn't willing to let go. So I had to let go of some things. I mean, a lot of people said just walk away from all the properties, and that's what a lot of people did, just let them all go into foreclosure. I just couldn't in my heart and soul let that happen. You know, all the tenants would have been kicked out, and I wouldn't have, you know, fulfilled the obligations that I had promised to do. So I had to figure out a way to like modify mortgages. You know, oh, we were losing, so we were just paying bills with credit cards, just get more and more debt. I mean, we were just making less and less and paying more and more and just going deeper and deeper in debt. And I'd cut back everything. I mean, I really never bought my kids new clothes. I feel a little bad admitting this, but their whole life, they got hand-me-downs. I'm so blessed in having so many great friends and family who gave me things, and my kids were open to that. I didn't call them hand-me-downs. I'd just say, oh, look at this great box of clothes from Amy. Let's go through and see what exciting new dresses you have, you know, and I would make it a big exciting adventure thing. But, I did a lot of things that, you know, you have to do when you have more money going out than you have coming in. You know, we managed to not, you know, get kicked out of our house, and, you know, to keep a roof over the head and food on the table, and, you know, and everything else is secondary. But if you're stressed out all the time and yelling at your kids all the time, something is wrong, and you have to recognize it and you have to fix it. And so I knew I had to get to a place where I wasn't spending so much time on this business, and where it wasn't losing so much money. The whole point of starting a side business is to make money, not lose money. And sure, some people, you know, get business loans or property loans and go into debt to build something up, but you have to have a plan for when eventually making money. And it's been a long, hard road to get to the point where, okay, you know, should I keep this if it's still costing me money? Again, we're still thinking about the long term. You know, someday in the future, is there gonna be, you know, a time when it's making money and it will help with retirement? But the point is that if you're working a couple jobs, which basically I was, I didn't want to admit it because it was just my thing I was doing at home, but this was another job and it was taking up too much of my time. So I had to figure out how to reverse that, and it took a lot of years, and I never stopped doing what I loved in my TV news job, but eventually new management came in and they went in another direction, as they always say. And after 15 years of working at the same station doing a job I loved, I was sad to leave when I was told, you know, they weren't gonna put me on the schedule anymore, but I was grateful for having had that time. And I then, when I stopped doing that, was trying to figure out what to do next. And one of the things I came up with was I love doing stories about people. It doesn't have to be about television news, or it can just be stories about moms and the struggles that they're going through. And I came up with this idea that, you know, there should be something out there that where moms can watch stories about other moms. And and they can watch these stories and relate to them and go, yeah, I went through something kind of similar too, and I felt like I was the only one, because during this time, I didn't even have time to talk to my girlfriends or my family or anybody about this. I just was, everything was on me, and I should have reached out more. I should have gotten more help. I should have recognized things sooner. I wish there had been, you know, more resources for me to find that told me other moms are going through this too and it's okay, because I really felt like, oh my God, I'm just completely screwed up and screwing up myself and my kids and my family. And, you know, I mean, it put my marriage in jeopardy. My kids still to this day say, you yell a lot, you yell too much. I mean, I don't feel like I hardly yell anymore at all because I've gotten past a lot of this, but I spent several years where that was just all the time. I was just stressed out all the time. And so when I stopped working in television news, I thought, okay, I can concentrate on the real estate and try to stabilize that business. And I did do that for a little while, but I wasn't happy because, like I said, that wasn't my passion. Not that you have to do something you love every second of the day, but if you have something that you know feeds your soul, you can't just let it go and stop doing it. I think a lot of people recognize that who have found something like that in their life. And so I decided I wanted to do stories about moms and their struggle and then share them with other moms so they could watch and realize that they're not alone, that other moms are going through this, and that when it gets to that point where you're so stressed out, where it's affecting your health, where you feel like every day when you're with your kids, you feel bad later because I shouldn't have yelled at them. We all lose our temper now and then or get impatient, but it shouldn't be an ongoing thing where you're just constantly blaming your husband for every problem that's going on. You know, you have to take a step back from that and say, what's wrong here? What, you know, am I trying to do too much? Is that what's causing this? I mean, and in the long run, that's really, there were a lot of stresses going on, you know, financially, emotionally, everything else, you know, my house is a wreck, and then your kids are getting old. And they're pushing back more and they're involved in more activities, and I felt I had to be there at all of them. I wanted to take them to all their activities and watch them in their karate class and in their soccer practice. I didn't want to just drop them off. I wanted to be there, and then I tried to be there and be, you know, doing my emails while I was there. But it's too much. You can't be multitasking every second of your life. So when I tried to just focus on the real estate, it didn't really help. It didn't, you know, I mean, sometimes it's a cyclical thing, you know, and when your heart's not in it and you're kind of missing something else, you're not going to maybe be the best business person you can be. So my husband got more involved, and that was a great thing. He got his real estate license, he got more involved, and we got other people involved to help us out, you know, with some of the management work. And then I decided I needed to start focusing back on doing journalism again and started writing for some local papers. You know, I started reaching out to other people. I reached out to a cousin of mine who had become a journalist after I had. She had reached out to me in the beginning when I was a journalist and she wasn't, to get some advice. And now I reached out to her because she had gone further in her career and was writing for prestigious newspapers. And she said, just contact your local paper and start writing again. And so I started getting back to doing what I loved. And then I got this idea to do a YouTube channel and to really produce video stories on a regular basis to share and to start a movement of moms recognizing that it's awesome that we have all these choices, but we don't have to do everything. And if a mom wants to work full time and have other caregivers raise her kids, that's awesome if that's what she wants to do. If a mom's working full time, but she really wants to work part time and be with her kids the rest of that time, figure out a way to do it. And I encourage you to tap into so many resources out there to figure out a way to do that, because that's your perfect work-life balance. And if a mom says, no, I'm not gonna work for a while or for the whole time my kids are home, that's your choice and that's what you should do. And if you're not doing that, figure out a way to do it. And if you do that and then you realize, uh-oh, I'm going crazy, I'm not happy being a stay-at-home mom, that's okay too. Sometimes the grass looks greener on the other side. I had a mom who told me for years and years and years, she worked 5 days a week. She's like, oh, I wish I could do what you do. I wish I could work 2 days a week. said, it's awesome. And she kind of started to try to build a side business to do that, but it didn't end up working out. And as far as I know, she still works full time. She got through it. I don't know if she would have felt more balanced working part time. Maybe she just eventually got to the point where she found the right balance. Sometimes as your kids' ages change, it helps too. But it's not gonna always be the same. You might find that you have the perfect work-life balance and then something changes, or you think you want it a certain way and then you try it out and it's not what you think. But the choices are what's important, and making the choice for yourself. And it's okay to be selfish. I'm not saying be a bad mom, ignore your kids. I mean, you have to know in your heart that if you're not with your kids, somebody's taking care of them and they're doing a great job. I talked to a mom a little while ago who said, you know, I didn't want to put my child in daycare, but he loves it. It's perfect for him. And every time I go there, I get this great feeling and I know this is the right place for him. And I'm glad I'm working full time, and I'm glad he's in daycare and he's at the right place. So you just have to know that, and then you're a calmer mom. You're not gonna be calm every second, but I really encourage you to find the work-life balance. I know it's such a cliche thing, but just find what works for you. And if the career you're in is not the right career, take steps to change it. If the hours and the days you're working are not right for your schedule and your family, find a way to change it. It's not easy. It's not going to happen overnight. It may take a lot of effort, a lot of looking. Reach out to me, leave comments, tell me what are you struggling with. Let me try to give you some advice based on all the moms I interview and my own life. That's what I want to do. I was able to create new goals and a new vision for myself as part of my working mom journey. And I want you to be able to do the same thing. So check out the next video where I explain how I started a new beginning so that you can get some inspiration to start your own new beginning. And most importantly, we all need some help. So don't forget to spread a little of your own love to another mom who needs it.